So hello everybody. I can't see much from here, so I guess there is everybody. I will talk about Bonobo, which is an ETL for Python 3.5, so it's not really polyglots, but maybe in the future it will be. Quickly, I'm Romain Dorgueil. I'm working as a startup advisor at L'Atelier BNP Paribas. We are running startup accelerators. And so I started 6 months ago to write something called Bonobo, which is an ETL. And ETL means extract, transform, load. It's definitely not new. It's something that, according to Wikipedia, is popular since 1970s. And it's a bit hidden, but it's kind of everywhere. And I mean, every time you have more than one data store talking about some data, you will need some way to make the different data store communicate and the master data replicate with the slave data. So as long as you have more than one data source for one data, you will have some kind of ETL. The concept is very simple. Is you have a stack of data. You take one line at a time. You put it in a first transformation. When it's finished, it goes to the second one. And while it's handled by the second one, the second line can be handled by the first one. So it's parallel, but it's one line at a time, really, I guess. In the real world, there will be databases, there will be logging, there will be mails, there will be anything, but it's the concept is simple. So let's see how it looks in Bonobo. Installing it should be as easy as pip install Bonobo. Then you can create a project. Here I create a polyconf project. If we write some code, here it's very simple code, but I took some data on Wikipedia about la geode. So I created a tuple of some data. I create a simple Python function. I hope everybody can read Python, otherwise it would be simple anyway. So I just split on the first comma and return whatever is before. And then I create a graph structure which just explain what data flow we're expecting. Here it's a very simple and linear data flow. It's just like a list. But you have API methods to just create forks and joins and everything. Once you did that, you can Bonobo run the directory or file, and it will show a bit of statistics of every node in the graph, how many inputs, how many outputs, and of course the output of print that was in the graph. The bonobo.graph data structure is very simple. In fact, it's a list of nodes and a list of edges, probably nothing very special here about graphs. It can store any Python object. Of course, when you run it, it's expected to have some properties, but not a lot, we'll see. So that's the graph. When you using either bonobo.run on a graph or you use the CLI to do bonobo run on the file or the directory, it will take again this graph and put a bit of machinery around that. It will add a context and a thread for each node, and it will add a Python FIFO queue between each node to make the nodes communicate. But that's implementation details. You don't have to know it, but it's just to understand what Bonobo is really doing behind the scene. So what can we put as nodes in a graph? You can use a bunch of different very standard Python. So you can use standard function. If you have one input that needs to be transformed in one output, you can use regular functions. You can use generators if you have one output and want to yield like 0, 1, or n outputs. You can use iterators if you don't have any input, but you just want to yield data into the workflow, into the data flow. And you can use basically anything that is callable by Python. So here I'm using some tools provided with Bonobo. But if you have a callable object, you can use it. We provide some tools like this, which is bonobo.config.configurable, which allows to specify options and services, because when you write complex transformation, you will have to usually have options and services to explain what a service is. Here we have a database service. We don't want to provide any implementation. We don't want to tie it to any SQL database or specific implementation. So we just say, okay, I will need a database service called database.default, and let's see later what the operator will provide me. And when you want to run it, you will just provide any kind of implementation, which means you can easily test your transformation by providing like some mock database when you're testing and just testing the transformation and not the external dependencies. Bonobo is bundled with a few candies. There is some stuff in the standard library that allows to read files, read standard formats, write standard formats. It's not yet complete. There will be much more, but you can start playing with that. There is also some lifecycle operation like limit and filter. There is something to output stuff. Nothing really fancy here. There is a plugin which activates when you run the CLI in an interactive terminal. That will, oh yes, it's very dark on the screen. So unlike what we think, there is things here. It will show while it's running the input and output statistic, number of errors in each node. There is the exact same thing that runs in Jupyter Notebook. If you don't know Jupyter, definitely check it out. You will see it's less fancy, but you will see the exact same statistics in a widget. And there is extension, so it's external package, not bundled with Bonobo because I wanted to stay very light, but there is a SQL Alchemy extension that provides connection with SQL database using SQL Alchemy. There is a Docker extension that allows to run C anything you would be able to Bonobo run. So you can run Bonobo transformation within Docker containers. And yeah, that's all. The time is very short, so in 10 minutes I can't show you a lot more. Just to summarize, Bonobo is very young. It's the first commit was 6 months ago. It had an ancestor library that ran for like 6 years, but the Python 3.5 and after library Bonobo is just young. And I'm targeting to have a stable API, so what I call 1.0, at the end of the year or early next year. And the only keyword here is light. The aim is, there is a lot of data tools out there, so the only aim is to have something to work on small-scale data, to have 1 minute to install, very easy to deploy and easy to test. I'm not trying to challenge all the big data library out there, the statistics and data analytics like Pandas. That's not at all the topic of Bonobo. It's just lean manufacturing for data. Or I'd like to build data processing for humans. So if you're interested, read the bonobo-project.org. If you're not, read it anyway. It won't kill anybody. And more importantly, let me know what you think. If you think it's just crap, let me know. If you think it's amazing, let me know. If you think anything else, I provide a way for you to let me know because we don't have time for any question. Just type this huge URL here. I didn't think the screen would be so big. So just type this URL or just scan this QR code. I don't know if it works on geodesic things. But yeah, you have a way. And if you can't, you can just follow me on Twitter. And I should have tweeted like a few minutes ago the presentation. So you will find the link anyway. Thank you very much.